Today class I'll go for non-uniform thermal conductivity for slab, and also I solve few problem. Along with that, I'm going to solve some resistance, material resistance series and parallel. I'll take an example and I'll give the answer for that and can write a answer for that. See, this is very easy. Thermal resistance in series and parallel. How to take the equation while solving the problem, how to write the resistance network, that is electrical analogy, that I am going to give in detail. The previous class I discussed about variable thermal conductivity, when the known temperature boundary conditions are given, how to take the unknown temperature and the middle of the slab, and also when the heat flux is given at the left side and the only one temperature is known, and how do you number 17 Today is the 24th and this is my 7th class, and coming to previous slide, I am going to just give the brief this is how the variable thermal conductivity, the derivation which I have done, assuming that is a unidirectional heat flow with variable thermal conductivity, and that is how the conductivity equation are taken, d by dx of k into dt by dx is equal to 0, where k is the function of temperature and k naught is 1 plus of alpha t. It means conductivity is a function of temperature, then the variable thermal conductivity is taken as k naught 1 plus of alpha t, where alpha is the thermal diffusivity. If you differentiate that equation substituting k value, you will get this equation. Again, I'll fresh up and then go there. So once again, I'll repeat the. So this is after integration. What are the equations that you are going to get? This is the first equation you are going to get, and the second equation you are going to get after repeating the integration with respect to x once again. Okay, by using boundary condition. Look at the using boundary condition that x is equal to t1 and x is equal to t2 when x is equal to L. This is x is equal to 0 and x is equal to L. The temperature is equal to T1, the temperature is equal to T2. And that boundary condition already repeatedly telling you the boundary conditions which are already given. You know this is the temperature T1, the heat is flowing Q, and this is the temperature T2 at x is equal to L, and this is x is equal to 0. Total length of the slab is L, and K is the thermal conductivity, where K is equal to K naught 1 plus of alpha T in the variable thermal conductivity which I have taken. The heat is flowing like this. This is what the boundary condition. It is simple heat transfer boundary conditions that I have taken, already written there. So the after substituting these two boundary conditions, you get two equations. You can solve those equations by substituting a suitable boundary condition. You will get the T mean temperature and C1 value is this. Already I covered this. And C2 value, already you know that C2 value become substituting in this equation, the temperature distribution equation. You will get the quadratic equation. Again, this quadratic equation in terms of T you can solve. You will get the temperature in this format. And this is given in heat transfer data and book, don't put over. Okay, that page number and other things you have to refer and then understand. Okay, the temperature distribution, when the temperature of the two sides are known, this is very important. When the two sides are known means this side is also known and this side is also known, and then in that situation this is the temperature holds good for that. And heat flow through this slab of thickness L, this is the temperature distribution Q you have to calculate. How much is the Q? This value you have to calculate. That can be calculated by assuming the Fourier's law of thermal conduction. Q is equal to minus K into dt by dx at x is equal to 0. And then substituting the variable thermal conductivity minus k naught 1 plus alpha t into a dt by dx at x is equal to 0. You know that dt by dx is equal to c1 times k naught 1 plus alpha. Already you derived that c1 there, the previous pages. Substituting c1 in the above equation, you will get this heat flow equation. This heat flow equation is in terms of A and also 1 plus of alpha t, that will be get cancelled here. So L remains k naught by L 1 plus alpha t m, you will get this values get and multiplied by A into t1 minus t2. So where km is equal to k naught 1 plus of alpha t m, if we take this become a simple heat conduction equation, but km value should be this you have to take. It means while solving problem, T mean temperature, T1 plus T2 divided by 2 is the T mean temperature, arithmetic mean you have to take, and then multiplied by the cross sectional area, exposed normal to the direction of heat flow, perpendicular to the board, cross sectional area is perpendicular to the board you have to take, and the temperature difference across the slab, you can also calculate. Equation become very simple, but only thing is the temperature distribution equation, if you are not able to remember, you can go to data handbook and see the data handbook, from there you have to take that. And that is a very much necessary, because it's very difficult to remember that equation, the length equation, and that cannot be. By practice, you can keep referring the data handbook, you will get it. Okay. Steady state unidirectional heat flow through a non-uniform conductivity with heat generation. So without heat generation, again, this is another derivation which I made an effort to calculate. When the heat flow is given, that is a heat flow through this slab, okay, unidirectional heat flow, it means Q is flowing and we don't know the temperature other side of the wall, okay. By substituting the boundary condition, again you will get the differential equation in this form. This is the, again it will be a differential equation. Dt by dx you have to evaluate by considering the Fourier's law of thermal conduction using boundary condition at t is equal to t1 and x is equal to 0. By substituting that integrated equation, you will get c1 is equal to this value. Again, substitute back in the same equation, you will get t1 and t, where in this
this remains same, but only thing is T1 is known, T2 is not known.
This is another boundary condition.
So here Q is anyhow flowing straight away. T1 is known, Q is known, and T2 is not known. I don't know anything about this surface temperature, but all remaining properties are known to me. Okay, from this, how do you evaluate?
So by simple heat conduction equation formula you have to use and then integrate it. After integration, you will get the constant C1 like this. After substituting the first boundary condition, C1 you will get this. Again, you substitute back in the equation. And after simplification, you will get temperature distribution in terms of heat flux, that is Q. So this is only a simplification. You can simplify this equation till you get a separate the quadratic equation you will get. From this quadratic equation, you can also substitute in the b plus or minus b square minus 4ac divided by 2a. A is alpha. Okay, that you can take. A is alpha by 2. You can substitute, you will get 2 into alpha by 2 is only alpha only you get. Okay. That way to rearrange, and this equation is also available in data handbook. So the heat flux is Q.
that can already there, and that is why I derived Q by A is heat flux. It means watt per meter square. Energy supplied is watt per meter square. Again, further simplification, you will get this equation. There are equations available for different boundary conditions. Now, I'll start with the today class 24-2-2020. This is my 7th class, I think. Another 3 classes are left out. I only solve numericals. Apart from that, and different exam problems, I am going to take up, and then I'll show you how to solve using a simple boundary conditions and given data, how you can solve this. Okay, another derivation left out is that unidirectional heat conduction with heat generation. So far you have done with variable thermal conductivity. Now I have to take up the derivation problem when the heat source is there at the center. I'll rewrite the figure once again. Anyhow, it is there on the board, but still I am going to write once again for the information. It means one should practice the way I am writing. Same way you have to practice it repeatedly. You will get an idea how you are going to write. Take a slab, and this is the heat source at the center. So this value is taken as 0 here from the center. So take the elemental volume element, okay, and this is the cross section, and perpendicular to the board there is a cross section, and this is thickness, and this value is, this is at x, can you see that, and this is dx, and this is L, and this is also L. From the center, this is, if you are taking L, that is it, or L by 2, if total unit is L, you can take L by 2. What is that I have taken? Total unit L I have taken, therefore it is L by 2. This length is L by 2. Total length is L. Right at the top, then it becomes clumsy. The total length of the slab is L. But the origin is at the center, here. It means heat generating source is there. In the temperature distribution, already I have shown this in the previous class. Still I am repeating. This is the temperature distribution. This is T max, maximum temperature. Because since the heat source is there, this is Q dot into A into dx. You can take like that. And this is the temperature T1, and here also temperature T1, since at the center we are taking. This is how the figure is considered. And again, we will go to the next, and the simple equation is that Qx is equal to minus Ka, Q is equal to minus Ka dT by dx is the formula. This is a Fourier term, law of thermal conduction equation that I am going to take. So here the heat generation, heat generated in the elemental dx is A into dx into Q dot, and heat conducted in x plus dx is, means after this strip, how much is the heat conducted out, that can be simplified. Finally, you get the Poisson's equation, that is equation 3.4. You will get it, d square t by dx square, dx square plus of q dot by k is equal to 0. So, this is the Poisson's equation. This equation can be made use for solving the, for deriving the equation with heat generation. This is the differential equation that is controlling differential equation for heat flow by conduction when the body is generating heat. So the integrate the above equation, what do you get? D by dt by dx plus q dot by k multiplied by x is equal to c1. Again, you integrate this equation once again, what do you get? T plus q dot by k, this is
x square by 2 plus c2. This equation you get. So by writing the boundary condition, dt by dx is equal to 0 at x is equal to 0. At x is equal to 0, what is the dt by dx value? You can write in the reverse direction. When x is equal to 0, what is the temperature gradient at the center? When x is equal to 0, dt by dx is equal to 0. Look at this. This is the center. Assume that x is equal to 0. This is x is equal to 0. And x is equal to L at this point. It means total length L I have taken. Therefore, half of it is L by 2. Half of it is L by 2 I have taken. So now, this x is equal to 0 here at the center. So substituting this boundary condition, what is the value you are going to get C1? Because dt by dx is here, if you substitute this value, x is equal to 0, c1 is equal to c1 become 0. You substitute these two quantities in this equation, you will get c1 equal to first boundary condition, putting the first constant, you are going to get c1 is equal to 0. And also you can put t is equal to t1 at x is equal to, look at that, at x is equal to L by 2. If you substitute this value, you will get c2 in terms of heat generation and temperature. This is substituting in this equation and second equation C2 I want T1 plus Q dot by K L square by 8 is equal to equation wrongly I wrote here. It's equal to C1x plus C2. This is correct. Second time we integrate C1x plus C2 you get. So that you can write C1 is anyway C1 is equal to 0, that will get cancelled, you get C2. So C2 is equal to T1 plus Q dot by K L square by 8, already it is there. Substituting C1, C2 in the above equation, in this equation. This is the equation 3.4, I think. Yes, 3.4. Substituting in the equation 3.5, you will get the suitable equation for you. The value of T is maximum when x is equal to 0. Substitute the value of x in the above equation 3.6. You will get the maximum temperature distribution. I'll take out this because the time space is insufficient to write the further equation. So the C1 and C2 you have to substitute. T plus Q dot by K into X. This is X square by 2. And this is equal to C1X. C1X is C1 is 0. And the X value is also 0. Therefore next plus C2 you have to write. C2 is T1 times plus Q dot by K, and this is L square by 8, this is C2. Okay, this equation you get. After simplification, taking T1, T in the left hand side, you can write the temperature distribution you want. This can be written as T1 plus Q dot by K, L square by 8 minus of Q dot by K, X square by 2. This you get. And you are taking the common factor Q dot L square by K, T1, Q dot L square is there, you can take L square, K you can take common factor, 8K you can take, multiplied by what you get, this whole unit I am going to take, 1 minus of, this is 2X by L, whole square effect. This is the simplified version. If the x value, if it is 0, what is the temperature you are going to get? X value if it is 0, can you
Can you try out that? X is equal to 0. Put in this equation x is equal to 0. This factor is going to be get cancelled. And you will get T maximum. Why T maximum? You will get the heat source is here. That is why you will get T maximum heat at this point. Therefore, T max is equal to T1 minus Q dot L square 8K. This is the answer. You know, by knowing the heat flux, at the center, you can calculate the temperature, maximum temperature, as well as by knowing the temperature at this, you can also find the temperature at anywhere at this point using this equation. This equation, I call this equation 3.6. 3.6 is the temperature distribution equation. At any value of x, here, anywhere any value of x, you can substitute x value, you will get the temperature at the particular point. Say x is equal to 1 centimeter, 2 centimeter, up to whatever the thickness of the slab you can take. That is why it is called as temperature distribution equation. The finite element analysis, using this, they are going to plot all the color graphs and which each pixel value represents the temperature. That's how the finite element analysis they are going to derive from this equation. So, they have to find the heat flow by using this. Again, Q is equal to minus K dt by dx. I think I made a sufficient effort to make you understand. And this equation is very much available in data and book. You can also refer, because different colleges using different data and book, and students are very familiar with Kodandraman, I suppose. And there are 4 or 5 data and books are available. I am referring Nijuguna, but you are not used to it because it's a big volume and it is containing, this is a thermal data and book. Heat transfer values are given like this. If you want, you can separately, you can take that book and then refer, or you can ask the librarian to procure that book and then use it, because it's a very good book. For finding out the heat flow, Q is equal to minus Ka dt by dx as x is equal to L by 2. Q is equal to minus Ka dt by dx at x is equal to L by 2. L by 2 means what? At this boundary, what is the heat is going out? Heat is going out like this. Q is going out because it is heating here and then it is going out like this. That you have to calculate. And you know that dt by dx at x is equal to L by 2, that is Q dot by K dot L by 2 will get, and substitute back into the equation. Finally, you will get heat flow is equal to Q dot A L by 2. This is the volume. It means the rate of heat generation watt per meter square. That is, this is heat generation. Usually, the unit for heat generation is watt per meter cube. Okay, that is the unit. So, now if you substitute the unit constant, you want to check watt per meter cube. This is meter square, this is in meter, and you will get all these quantities get cancelled. You will get heat flow is in watts only, energy flow is in watts only. Whatever the derivation I have done, it is correct because the unit consistency is there. Q is in watts and this value is also gives in watts. If this is the heat flow from one surface, so that the heat flow is from one surface. If the heat flow from both the surface, what you have to do? You have to multiply the above equation by 2. It means total heat is equal to, can you able to see? No, you can't able to see. I'll wipe off this portion. Right. And both the surface you have to see, Q total is equal to 2Q. So 2 times into Q dot A L by 2, 2 to get cancelled, you will get Q dot A L, that is Q total. Q total means on both the surface how much it is flowing. This again, it is the, this is in volume. This can be written as Q dot V. Q dot V means volume of the slab. Therefore, heat conducted is equal to heat generated. It can be written heat conducted is equal to heat generated. How much heat is generating? So much of heat is getting conducted. Therefore, we are equating and the equation whatever it derived is correct. Okay, this is how the heat generation for slab, that is in Cartesian coordinate only as gas, not for the cylindrical and spherical coordinate in your syllabus. So, I made an effort to bring out the heat conduction or heat flow through a slab of thickness L and with heat generation, with heat generating element at the center. So this is another example I quoted, and only one side is getting insulated, others what will be the heat conduction on the left side. Again, same equation you are going to get with a different format. Same equation you are going to get, but only thing, plate is considered given, which is generating heat uniformly and insulated at the one end, and that boundary condition dt by dx is equal to 0 only. That also you can take, you will get a different equation. Probably you may try out a different boundary condition and then solve, because the controlling differential equation remains same for uniform conductivity. Controlling differential equation is d square t by dx square is equal to 0. And for with the heat generation, d square t by dx square plus q dot by k is the differential equation for finding out the temperature distribution. And for finding out the heat flow, q is equal to minus ka dt by dx with uniform thermal conductivity. Without with variable thermal conductivity, I can write this as k naught 1 plus of alpha t a into dt by dx is the controlling heat conduction equation. With heat generation, if you want to, you can also take this equation. There are two equations I have written. One is these two club together. This is one equation. One set of derivations with the temperature distribution and heat flow. Another one is this with heat generation and variable thermal conductivity. You can also, not this one, same thing. Yeah, here with heat generation. When you are considering the variable thermal conductivity, you can use this equation and substitute k is equal to k naught in this equation. There you will get the. So you have to practice. Then only you will be able to remember, but equation remains same. These are the two equations right from the beginning of the class. I am only using the second order partial differential equation and controlling differential equation. When t tends to 0, time tends to 0, these two are the controlling differential equation. So, I will take one example. Find the heat transfer through a composite wall. For unit area, assuming that equation example 2.9a for unit area, assume one dimensional heat flow shown in figure. It means the figure also shown here. I removed the figure number here. So this is the figure 29.a, and this is the composite. Already I have taken this. Again, I am repeating it because I'm going a bit fast. That is why I'm repeating the same problem. How do you write the resistance equation for the problems given? Because I'm covering two topics in one problem. That is resistance in series and also resistance in parallel. And also solving the problem for that. Suppose you consider a slab of thickness, and it is having a two slab again, like this. These are the different slabs of composite taken like this. This is the isometric drawing, already you have studied. So this is 1 meter square area. Cross-sectional area is how much? 1 meter square. And you know the distance is 3 centimeter, 8 centimeter. This is 3 centimeter, this is 8 centimeter. Another is 5 centimeter. These are the distance. You have to convert them into meters later and then calculate. You know that this surface temperature is around 400 degrees Celsius and this surface temperature is around 60 degrees Celsius. Heat is flowing through like this. And you have to find out the combined resistance I am going to write. So look at here, the combined resistance is, I am writing here only. This is one resistance. After that, this is another resistance because this is a bifurcation. And this is another resistance. Look together, become one more resistance here. And that can be written 1, 2, 3. See, suppose this is A, and what is the marking he has done? B, this is C, and this is D. So, this is A, B, C, D. So, you know that RA, RB, RC you have to calculate. RA, RB, RC, and RD. So, RB, RC equivalent to RE, I will call it as. RA, RB, RC, and RD. Because B and C are parallel. B and C are parallel. Therefore, they can club together and then calculate the resistance for RA, RB, and RC. Separately, you have to calculate RA and RB, RC. Then you can do the solution for that. And once again, the wipe top, only the resistance equation I am going to take. Any of the board gives the picture of it. I am going to take the resistance for RA, RB, and RC. Suppose I will read one more effort to write it once again. Here the temperature also noted. What is the temperature here? This is the temperature. 400 degree Celsius. What is the temperature at this point? This is 60 degree Celsius. This is RD. This is RA. This is RC. This is RB. Now the equations are given already there. So RA is equal to 1 divided by, that is LA divided by KA, LA divided by KA into AA. You know the length of the slab is 3 centimeter. 3 divided by 100. Why 100 I am giving? Because 10 centimeter is getting converted into meter. So, volt divided by 150 watt and multiplied by 1 meter. 1 minute. I'm sorry for the disturbance. you know the conversion is 3 centimeter by 100 is 3 meter and the resistance, the conductivity value is given for the first slab. First slab is 150 watts per meter Kelvin, that is 1 dot by 150.
The area that he has given is 1 meter, therefore 1 by 1.
So 1 meter only. If you appropriately calculate, what you get? This is equal to 0.2 into 10 raised to minus 2 Ugrad. What is this? This is in terms of degree Celsius per watt. Unit should be properly written. Most of the time, in the examination, what I observed during evaluation, the students fail to write the units. You have to practice the unit, how to write the unit also. Otherwise, it's very difficult to get full marks. So next, RB. RB is equal to, again, LB divided by KB into AB. LB divided by KB into AB. What is the length? 8 centimeter. 8 by 100 multiplied by the conductivity that he has given, 30. Multiplied by 0.5 meter, because half of it is, this is half, it is occupied, this is half, it is occupied in the square meter area. It means 0.5 square meter only it is occupied. For that I have taken 0.5 square meter, that is 1 by 0.. If you multiply all these factors, what do you get? 8 by 15 into 10 raised to minus 2, okay. That is also degree Celsius per watt. Capital W. So next RC. This is LC, KC by AC. Again, you write. And this can be written. Next, go to the next slide. Okay, RC is equal to. Again, 8 by 100 multiplied by the different, is having a different thermal conductivity, 1 by 65. Again, it is multiplied by 1 by 0.5 area. You will get 8 by 32.5 into 10 raised to minus 2 degree Celsius per watt. Again, RD. RD you are going to get 5 by 100, 5 centimeter divided by 100, the same equation you will get, divided by 1 by 50, 1 by 1, because this is this is conductivity, this is the length, and this is area. So that can be taken as 1 into 10 raised to minus 3. So the equivalence of RA, RB and RC can be taken as 1 by RC. 1 by RE is equal to 1 by RC plus 1 by RB. Substituting these two values in this equation, equivalent value that you are going to get, that is 100 into 5.3935. So that we are going to get equivalent. So RE value is 1.69 into 10 raised to minus 3. 1.69 into 10 raised to minus 3 you get. So how do you calculate the heat flow for all these three? It means the resistance in parallel is made into equivalent of resistance in series. Resistance in parallel. Look at here, RB and RC are in parallel. Made it resistance in series by calculating the R value. So that can be substituted in the heat conduction equation. That is, Q is equal to T1 minus T2 divided by RA plus RB, RE plus RD. You can substitute all these values. This is 400 minus of 60 whole divided by 0.2 into 10 raised to minus 3. First value, this value. R is 1.69 into 10 raised to minus 3.
multiplied by 1 into 10 raised to minus 3. After simplification, you will get the resistance, the heat flow value is 118 kilowatt. Small k, capital W. This is what the resistance you are going to get. It means the heat flow you are going to get through this lab by knowing the thermal conductivity of various materials arranged in series and parallel. This is one of the kind of equation used for analyzing theoretically how the equations are this electrical network or series and parallel. Both I combined and then give an example with the thermal conductivity and temperature boundary conditions. I calculated the heat flow. So the another problem, furnace wall is made of 75 mm thick fire clay brick and 6.4 mm thick inside surface of the brick is 647 degrees Celsius and outside air temperature is 27 degrees Celsius. The shell is made out of mild steel. Determine the heat loss per meter square area of the furnace wall and outside surface temperature of the steel plate. If 18 steel bolts each of 19 millimeter diameter are used to for fixing the steel plate on the brick wall per meter square area of the wall, what is the percentage increase in the heat flux? It means he has used 18 bolts to fix the metal plate to the fire clay bricks, and how much is the heat enhanced by fixing 18 bolts on that. Percentage of increase in the heat flux you have to calculate. Take K brick is equal to 1.5 watt per meter degree Celsius and K steel for, that means K steel means thermal conductivity of brick and thermal conductivity of steel is equal to 39 watts per meter degree Celsius, where H naught is the outside heat transfer coefficient, that is equal to 68 watt per meter square degree Celsius. These are the some of the data are given. So assume taking all these data, I am going to write the electrical network. You can write the electrical network for all the problems because that gives the very simple equation, gets simplified further, so they can use. See, analogous to electrical circuit are shown in figure, considering the unit surface area. Unit surface area means perpendicular to the board is the unit area that we are going to, cross sectional area. Perpendicular to the board is called the surface area for the heat flow. Okay, I am using two words here, on the surface area and cross sectional area. How can it be similar for heat flow? I'll make an effort to make you understand that when this slab is given like this, this is the thickness of this slab. Okay, heat is flowing like this. When the observer is standing here, this is the front portion and you are taking this as length L. Okay, I'll write why to write the face. This is the eye of the observer. Okay, then the area exposed is normal to the direction you flow is the perpendicular, this is cross section. To the direction of heat flow, it is a surface area. Okay, that is the meaning of it. Don't get confused, otherwise we are going to write this, not the three-dimensional object. We need transfer. Always you take only two-dimensional object and then keep solving, assuming that area perpendicular to the board is taken as a surface area for the flow of heat. That is how we are going to take. So there are two electrical analogy network I have written there. So the one is a brick, another one is steel, another one is conductivity. Shall I write that? So I'll write the three-dimensional object only now, so that it will be easy for you to understand. It is not there in the slide, but I make an effort to write. This is the, and one more slab of thick shell is there, stainless steel shell is there. This is the stainless steel shell. Okay, and air is there. There are three media. One is fire brick,
steel, this is a fire brick, this is a steel, this is air. Three medias are there. So, summarizedly, you can write all the three media like this. One is brick, another is steel, another is air. Air cannot be written because only dotted line can be shown. This is how you are going to write. How do you write electrical analogy for this? First one is one resistance, second resistance, and third resistance. Three resistance I have shown. 1, 2, 3. Okay? So the here also I can write. This is the wall, one resistance. This is the wall, another resistance. Again, it can be written as another resistance. This is for this, and this is for this, air for this. That's what he has taken. And I am just simplified to show you how the slab thickness and cross section is taken here of solving the problem. But you have to imagine and then analyze and then start writing the equation. So summarizedly, I can write T1 is the temperature, heat is start flowing, this is temperature, and this is temperature T2, and this is the steel, this is T3, and this is air, and this is temperature T4. Three resistance media taken, and he has taken in the TA is equal to air temperature, T3 has not shown at all. So we can write resistance of brick, R brick is equal to 1 by, that is L1 by K A. A is 1 meter square, where A is equal to 1 meter square, unit area is taken. So therefore, that is what is L1 by K, that is equal to 1.01. Length is 0.075, already given in the problem. The resistance value you get. And steel similarly per meter square. The conductivity of steel is 39 watt per meter degree Celsius. You'll get 1.64 into 10 raised to minus 4. Unit I have not written. You got to write the unit. For brick it is degree Celsius per watt. Or steel is equal to LS by KS into AS. AS is 1 again. This is also degree Celsius per watt. You can write. And also, the air resistance, convective resistance you've got, or convection resistance, it is 1 by H naught. 1 by H naught. That is equal to 0.041. This is also degree Celsius per watt. So now, substituting all these values, combining all these values, you will get total resistance, that is T1 minus TA divided by R total. You can substitute what is the temperature value you have taken there? 647, no? The temperature of 647, yes. This is the 647 degree Celsius. Look at here, 647 degree minus 27 you have to take. That's what I have taken here. 647 minus 27 divided by the total resistance, you will get 7460 watt per meter square. So the next case, again it is going to take heat flow per square meter area, T1 minus T2, R brick plus R steel only is taking. Substituting that, you will get the intermediate temperature T3 is equal to 137 degrees Celsius. For that, electrical analogy is differently is using. Say, this is how is using. R brick plus steel, and also R convection. So, this is how the resistance arrangement is made, and this is what he is asking to calculate the combined resistance. 18 bolts are used. 18 bolts are used, no? For that, he is adding the those resistance. Bolts resistance is also adding in parallel to the brick and steel. So, the brick and steel and also bolts are together. How we can add a board? So, the three, this is brick and this is T, and this is a convection heat transfer, and you are adding 19 bolts and nuts here like this. Okay. Like there are how many bolts are there? 18 bolts are there. It means this and this are series and this is parallel. Okay. For that, what I have to write? Same the equation what he has written, the electrical analogy what he has written here. This one I am telling. This is in series and this series is parallel with the bolts. Okay. And our convection as it is he has taken. That you know how to take the when it is in series, how to take that also I told you in the previous example. Same way you can take and then you can calculate the temperature T3 because you already know the heat transfer 7460 for combined and that you substitute find out the temperature. That becomes very simple. The minimum length of the bolt through which the conduction takes place is equal to thickness of the composite wall. That length you have to take 8.41 centimeter. You get thermal resistance for 18 bolts can be calculated by using the again R bolt is equal to L by KB AB, where AB is the cross sectional area of the each bolt 18 bolts, that is pi d square by 4. Already 19 centimeter, I think 19 millimeter is given for bolt. That area you have to take and conductivity of the material you have to take. Here the conductivity of the material area you have to take. And 18 bolts number you have to multiply, you will get the total area and you will get this the bolt resistance that you have to substitute in the equation, that is 1 by bolt plus combined brick. You will get the combined resistance, equivalent resistance for the second case. Total resistance of the circuit B is given, RT is equal to 0.0694. It is very easy and you substituting total resistance you will get this much heat. It means the heat transfer rate increases because you are adding metal in between these two walls. The temperature is keep on increasing. The heat equivalent, heat flow per meter square area when the 18 bolts are added to the wall, you will get percentage increase in the heat flow is 8930 minus 7460 watt divided by 7460 watt multiplied by 100. You will get 19.7% rise in the increase in the temperature by addition of the bolt. Is it detrimentally is affecting the performance of the boiler? Yes, definitely, because you are increasing 19.7% of heat is unnecessarily flowing out of the system. That has to be avoided. It means for that what they are going to do, they are going to put a cladding here, aluminum cladding with glass hoods like this. It means this prevent that 19% of heat also. It is not necessary to, because you want to see the strength also. As an engineer, you should design the sufficient strength for the withholding the fire brick as well as temperature as well as structure, because we are melting the iron inside. That way you have to see that, and also you should not compromise with the heat flow. Unnecessarily you are allowing the heat to flow 19.7% is a huge loss. So anyhow, the problem is given for only analysis, and this is how we analyzed. And the temperature T3 after the combined, after putting the bolt, what is the temperature? Earlier temperature, the temperature was reduced. Putting the bolt, it is getting reduced. But heat is increased, temperature is getting reduced. So, this shows that steel's surface temperature is decreased by 14 degrees Celsius because the bolt is transmitting the heat in a different direction, in the same direction, but this temperature is decreased because of the addition of bolts. See, I think composite cylinders is not included in your syllabus, but he has asked you to write the resistance in series, resistance in parallel, and even the composite cylinder is also comes under resistance in series and resistance in parallel also. Usually composite cylinders are resistance in series only possible to put, because you cannot club parallel and series together. It's not a slab material. You know, the walls are, the bricks are constructed, bricks are staggered way you are constructing the brick. That way you cannot able to do it here. It's possible to do it when you are putting in, so cylindrically you have to take that composite, and it become very complex situation. That is why he has not mentioned only Cartesian coordinate system only you have to calculate like that. He has given any little effort is made to. So you can also study this as a syllabus of interest, and any problems asked you can also go through this, because the composite cylinder having three layers I've taken 1, 2, 3. This is the first composite. Second, two layers I've taken, resistance R1, R2 I've taken like this. T1, T2, T3 is the surface temperature, and H0, HI are the convective transfer inside and outside the hollow composite. The general equation for that is heat conducted is equal to, first heat is convected from inside wall, inside of the cylinder to the wall of the first cylinder, next to the second cylinder, then convected out from the surface of the, because two resistance are not written here, the inside convective resistance, outside convective resistance are not written, but the equation has been written there. Okay, so this is the convective heat to the wall, first wall, second wall, and then convective heat out of the third wall. Therefore T1, T2, T3 are get cancelled. You'll get, adding all the above terms, you'll get this equation. This equation for n layer you can write like this. This is the one of the conduction equation for cylindrical part, that is Q is equal to 2 pi L T1 minus T2 divided by R. You can write this. The denominator portion is completely a resistance portion. So the first resistance inside R0 plus the wall resistance, like that you can write. This is the resistance inside, resistance outside, and this is the resistance for the wall. So here 2 pi L T1 minus TI minus T0 is taken. This is one. Similarly for spherical hollow sphere with the composite media, hollow composite sphere I taken, similarly it is added, all the equations are added, finally you will get the equation. This is the n composite layer for the hollow sphere, and these are the resistance inside, the convective resistance outside, plus the conduction resistance here, 4 pi of Ti minus T0, you will get this equation. This is only for academic interest you can ready, and sometimes the problem may be asked in this, on this composite cylinder, composite sphere, you may be able to solve these two problems. Okay, say the overall heat transfer coefficient you need to understand, because how the overall heat transfer coefficient is considered for a slab. Taking the plane wall having a thermal conductivity K with the thickness L as shown in figure, the wall separates the hot and cold fluid, temperature T0. Let us denote the surface temperature as T1, T2. So here let us denote the surface temperature T1, T2. This slab is separating the hot fluid and cold fluid. And hot fluid definitely it will get heated up the surface, and then conducts the heat through the length of the slab, and then finally it conduct out. Okay, plane slab is taken, and this again similar boundary conditions I consider. This is the air temperature, this is the wall temperature T2, inside wall temperature is T1, conductivity K, and length of the slab is L at x is equal to 0 and at x is equal to L here. So this is what you have taken. Simple conduction equation with the thermal resistance it can be taken. Q by A is equal to with the experience I can directly write. So what you are going to write, Q is equal to minus Ka dT by dx you are going to write, isn't it? So I can write K instead of A only you can write. Instead of dT by dx, L is dx is equal to L. dT is T1 minus T2 you can write. I can write directly like this. dT is T1 minus T2. dx is the total length of the slab. This is dx is equal to L, and here the temperature difference is T1 minus T2, because it is in the decreasing gradient, that is why T1 minus T2 I am going to take, and this equation. So what are the resistance if you consider this is HI and this is H naught and this is thermal conductivity K. Three properties of the fluid. Property of fluid at inside, material property, conductivity, and also the conductivity, see, material property or the fluid property at the outside of the wall. It means this is inside and this is outside. T1, T2 and dx is equal to L. Substituting that value, you will get this equation. This is very simplified equation. And how do you write the resistance for that? Resistance is Q is equal to T1 minus T2. This is L by Ke. This is R. This is T1 minus T2 by R. Okay, this is how I want to write. This is HI. So how many medias are there? Okay, I'm going to write here one inside convective resistance, the wall resistance. Again, it is convective resistance at outside. Three are there. How do you write all those things? If for a given area, this is T1 minus T2. Simply, I can write this is 1 by HI. 1 by HI for unit area. This is 1 by H naught. First word, conductivity, you have to write. How do you write? This is L divided by Ka plus 1 by H naught. This is the resistance, 1, 2, 3. Call this equation 1. Go to the next. Heat flow through the slab. Rate of heat flow can be written as, with considering the overall heat transfer coefficient U, Q is equal to UA T1 minus T2. This is the overall heat transfer coefficient for air, not for slab. This is conductivity. So this can be written as Q is equal to A into T1 minus T2. This is 1 by U I can write. It means equation can be get modified. Call this equation 2. So equating where U is known as overall heat transfer coefficient, equating equation 1 and 2, what do you get? 1 by U is equal to what? This equation and this equation be equated. 1 by U is equal to 1 by HI plus 1 by L by Ka plus 1 by H naught. And this is the overall heat transfer coefficient equation. Where 1 by U is known as total thermal resistance of a system for n composite wall, then overall heat transfer coefficient can be written as 1 by U of plus 1 by HI plus 1 by H naught plus sigma of n is equal to n is equal to 1. This is Ln by K n. For unit area, A is taken A for unit. It means for unit cross section area, unit surface area you are going to take. Perpendicular board, unit cross section area. When it is exposed normal to depth, then you can take surface area. Similarly, for n composite cylinder, you can write that equation, and sphere also that equation can be written. So where U is the overall heat transfer coefficient. This is also given. This equation is, these all the three equations are given in the data handbook. You can take down and note down all those things. I can refer, after writing this equation, you can refer the data handbook. You will get the ready-made equation there only. You can, and different forum he has given, but unit remains the same. What is the unit for this equation? I can ask you the question, what is the unit for this equation? You can also simplify and write, tell me the unit. So this is 1 divided by watt per meter square degree Celsius is there. Here also it is 1 divided by watt per meter square degree Celsius plus 1 divided by, this is L is meter again, K is watt per meter degree Celsius, this is area is in
meter square plus 1 by watt per meter square degree Celsius.
If you simplify, what you get finally, you will get meter square degree Celsius per watt. This is equal to meter square degree Celsius per watt you are going to get. Unit consistency is there. You can also check it. If any problem is there, you can leave a, you can ask your teacher at the class, and that is how the equation is given. For any equation you are writing or checking the data handbook, they are all homogeneous equation, and unit consistency is maintained writing all the equations. This is the overall heat transfer coefficient you have to remember, and equation is given in the data handbook. Again, I'll take one composite wall. Time is up.